Hello friends, hope you are doing well. My name is Dr. Milind Shinde, MD Pediatrics from AIIMS Bhopal. So as we all know, being a PG aspirant, particularly in India, is a very difficult task. We have a lot of problems. There are a lot of issues which are not in our hands. Like currently, if you see the recent developments, the NEET PG counseling again, has the verdict about it has been deferred. And students are going through a lot of mental torture because of this. This is something that is not in our hand, but those who are preparing for such a long time have given their everything, and there is a lot of uncertainty. Also, a lot of students are talking about how this kind of scheme is affecting their chances to get a good branch, a good college, a good city. So, you know, when I was preparing, my teacher always used to tell that, you know, give your best now, give your everything now, because, you know, Indian medical system is such thing that everything will be changing every six in a 6 month. So this is your best chance to achieve whatever dreams you have. It's very difficult, you know, these things are not in our hand. Again, as I said, that there's nothing really we can do about it. So instead of thinking about that, you know, don't waste so much of time, because a lot of people there will be there who will be discouraging you. Even these thoughts will be in your mind that the things are not going the right way. What if I get a seat next session and the similar things happen? You have to give your best. You have to put yourself in such a position that, you know, such things won't matter. Try best that get such a rank that it won't affect that your, you know, such things won't affect your situation. And don't worry about the things that are not in your hand. So look at the positive side. Now, if you are a PG aspirant over the last 1 year, like if you are going to write next NICT, that is going to be in June. So from last June to June, you would have written like so many exams. You wrote NICT this June, then NEET PG 2021, then again NICT in November. Then you'll be writing NEET PG in 2022 in March and NICT in May. So writing such five major exams in a span of 1 year is again a difficult task. But why I'm making this video is about learning from your mistakes. That what November 2021 NICT exam teaches us. That what are the learning points which we should, you know, like take into consideration for our better future, so we don't commit the same mistakes in the upcoming exam. A lot of students who wrote NICT 2021, they said they were not ready for it, they did not give it with the full heart. So that is not what you are going to do in the next exam. You have to write your NEET PG and NICT in the same enthusiasm, with the same preparation. Because as I have emphasized in my last few videos, this is going to be your best chance. Having five exams in 1 year has its one advantage, that a lot of students will be taking the seats in one or the other exam. So as you progress, the competition will also decrease. But you have to be ready for that. You have to place yourself in such a position that you get best out of it. So guys, don't be disheartened. Know that thing, you know, similar things happened with us also when we were writing our exam. It was always there. It is not something new. Be it a reservation, be it a number of seats or everything. Just don't get disheartened by because few people are mentioning they are not getting the seat they want despite having a good rank. They have done their part. They will get something or the other. Don't let yourself be distracted by such scenario. So do your best. You are going to get your dream branches. You have to tell that to yourself every day. So let's talk about what happened in the NEET PG exam or November 2021. So again, as I say that NICT is for the admission for AIIMS, PG and JIPMER, like INI stands for Institute of National Importance. It's a common entrance test for the PG admission in these exams. So if we talk about NICT November 2021, so most of the students, they rated this exam as a difficult one, as a difficult exam. But it was like not a very easy exam as compared to the previous, but see, you have written like 2-3 exams in such a short span of time. So NICT is supposed to be difficult. If you ask me, the topper in INI, like in AIIMS, it used to be AIIMS exam previously. So topper in AIIMS exam would correct 150 to 155 questions out of 200. Like they will attempt around 195-196 and they will get 150 to 155, and then the remaining people will cluster between 145 to 155. So that is the accuracy rate. I mean, it was always a difficult exam. So don't worry if people say that it is difficult. See, it's INI. It's the Institute of National Importance. So if you want name like AIIMS, JIPMER, PGI to be attached to your name, don't expect that it will be a walk in the park. It is going to be a difficult exam. Here you have to think. But it's not like, unlike NEET PG, you don't have to get 182 out of 180, 196, right? Here, getting 150 out of 182 will work in your favor, and you will get a very good rank and a very good seat in a central institutes. As I say, that central institutes have their own benefit. They are more research oriented. The name tag you get, the better salary you get, and there is no bond. After 3 years, you are free. And also, you can do a career in these such institutes. You can build a career, like you can have one of the best career if you go through the institutes. So the exam was of a difficult level. So what are the, why, how does it affect having a difficult exam or an easy exam? So I will always say that I would prefer to face a difficult exam, because when the exam is easy, your silly mistakes increases, and the silly mistake, they will affect your rank very badly. Even if you do a small, like 1-2 silly mistake, it will, as I have shown in my previous video, it will change your rank by thousands and literally take away your dream. So having an easy exam always cost you through the silly mistakes. Whenever exam is difficult, it's not only for you. Exam is difficult for everyone. Even the toppers, they will face the exam as a, they will rate it as a difficult exam. So here, if you get a more, even here your silly mistakes won't matter, because the amount of wrong questions done by other students will be equally, as they can be equitable to you. Though so, having a difficult exam, the clustering is not there. So you will get a better rank. So having a difficult exam is always a good thing. So there you can expect a better rank. So that's what I feel. So November 2021 was rated as a difficult for students. So we have to take into consideration that this is INICT. So June INICT would also be a difficult exam. So you have to be prepared and accordingly for that. So how to prepare for INICT, I have already released one video, and I will also be discussing things here. Then about time management. So AIIMS exam was always 200 questions, and the INICT is also the 200 question exam. So most of the students say that the time was adequate. And even I feel that 3 hours is an adequate time to write 200 questions. Yes, there are some lengthy questions, there are some image-based questions, but this is where you have to use your time wisely. Whenever you have a one-liner, there will be one-liner questions, there will be clinical questions. So you have to practice your GTs and you have to work on that. So whenever you're writing your GT, as I said earlier, write 1 or 2 GT in a month and spend your time wisely. See how much time you are taking, which questions are troubling you more, where you have to work. So if you work on that area, time issue will never be there. So that is also something that you have to take message from your recent November 2021 INICT. If you have written that exam, how was your time management? Were you able to address all 200 questions in a stipulated time? If not, then you have to know that which areas you have to address. So even if you are not prepared well for November 2021 INICT, take it as a learning tool for next 2 exams, because they are going to be both are going to be very important examinations of your life. Now about the subject distribution, that how was INICT subject distribution was there. So as given by a lot of students and the classes, the subjects which had a maximum were like patho, pharma, micro, PSM, obs gyne, orthopedics, FMT. So this question had a important weightage. I mean, as were told by the students, and other questions were there. But what was interesting, that a lot of students told me that they think the medicine was missing. I mean, they literally did not find a lot of questions from medicine. Also, surgery questions were very less. So again, guys, again highlighting the same point. These are what we called the rank building subjects and rank deciding subject. As I always tell, that you have to concentrate on that. And before exam also, I had told you that whenever you're reading the larger subject, start with the obs gyne, followed by PSM, followed by surgery, followed by medicine. Because that is what it is, not for today. This is what pattern is being followed for last 10 decade, I will say. So do not expect that. See what happens when you attend a lot of coaching classes. Exam is not said by the coaching classes or any person like me or you. Exam pattern is supposed to be changed. So you have to tick all the boxes. It is not like if any coaching classes has told you that these are the high yield points, or if I'm going to tell you that these are the high yield points or images. No, the examiner is not going to listen to the classes or me. he is going to exam pattern can change anytime. The question weightage can change anytime. But there is a fixed rule that maybe from rank building, patho, pharma, micro, they ask this thing. Next time they will give more weightage to, let's say, your anatomy, physio, and biochemistry. Instead of PSM and obs gyne, they might ask you surgery. Instead of orthopedics and FMT, they might ask from ophthalmopedia and derma. So that is something that you have to know. You cannot skip on any subject. Just because this exam gave weightage to this subject, it doesn't matter that you have to concentrate on only this subject. The next exam can be different. So whatever subject distribution that we have already discussed about rank building, maintaining, and deciding, that always should be on back of your mind. And you should not skip any subject. All subjects are equally important. Just you have to divide smartly, which we already discussed. Then I want to personally address one issue that has been troubling a lot of students about previous year's questions. So again, there are a lot of contradictory opinions by the students, like how helpful. See, earlier, like let's say 5 years back, the trend was such that most of the students used to follow previous year questions religiously. They used to solve last 10 year question. And what I had seen that these students used to have a very good outcome, and they used to have a very good ranks. But now the education and this teaching has changed to the app-based teaching. Like there are a lot of applications. So there are question banks. So instead of going for the previous questions, students are going more to the question banks. But see, if you see INICT 2021, so few students say there were not lot of repeats, but few students, there is one class which is saying there were 50 to 20 questions repeated from previous years and as long as 2015. So few questions were from 2015 also. So see, previous year questions is something like, you know, it's like a cheat code. And this is committing a mistake in a question which is repeated is a crime. And as I have told you that even doing a single mistake is going to affect your rank. So this is something that should not affect your rank. So I have said it in my previous videos, and again, I'm going to say the same thing, that follow previous year questions. I always advise students, be it for a NEET PG 2021 or your INICT, try to follow at least last 8 to 10 years questions. Because see what happens, the toppers who are ranked 1 to 10 or 1 to 20, 1 to 50, see what we do, like you people, I used to follow their interviews. So usually they do not emphasize on previous year questions. The reason being, they have been studying for last, like from their second year of their undergraduation, and they are like all gold medalists. So for them, it doesn't matter to know previous year questions, because anyway, they are going to get a good rank, even solving them, because they already have that knowledge. But the people who are like average, like me, and if you are feeling that you are an average student who have like we were very normal students during our MBBS life. So we have to take benefit of the previous year questions, because we cannot go back and read all the textbooks well. So if you do 8 to 10 years questions in these were previous year questions, so it is going to help you in a positive way. Do not see, you cannot follow someone else's idea. You cannot say that toppers have done it, so if I do the similar way, it is going to help you. You don't know what was their base. You don't know how they studied in MBBS. People say that I studied only 4 to 6 hours and I cracked NEET PG and AIIMS. So that doesn't mean that you can also do that, because that person had studied previously. You don't note that point. So don't follow blindly to anyone. What I feel, what the people have always said, the people who have cracked, that previous year questions very important, are important, and will always remain important. Because your first and second prof subject, they don't change that much. The pattern of question might change, but but you have to emphasize on that point, that you have to follow previous year questions and do not miss previous year questions. Again and again, I'm emphasizing on this point. Then whenever you are preparing for INICT, there is something that you have to see about image-based questions. So you have to see how were the image-based questions this year. So again, there was a lot of histological images, pathological images. So again, the standard textbooks, and there are some visual sessions carried out by certain coaching classes. So that you have to follow. So that can address the image questions. So good number of questions were from the image-based questions. Then one more point I want to add, that is different for INICT. That INICT is not only about AIIMS. It's also about PGI and JIPMER. So what PGI used to do, the PGI used to have multiple options correct. The MCQs were multiple answers. JIPMER was always about new drugs. They used to ask you a lot of new drugs and new advances. And also in PGI, they used to give like your assertion and reasoning. So they used to ask you about these kind of questions. So now NICT is about all. So what are they doing there? They're taking everything from all. So if you solve only MCQ banks, see what I have noticed that apps which give you MCQ banks, usually they have only single based answer. Not all apps and modules and question bank cater this purpose of NICT. Of knowing the multiple answers and match the following. So if you solve the last year question banks, like the question banks which contains all type of like AIIMS, PGI and JIPMER kind of questions, so that is also going to help you. Earlier we have to have one Chaudhary book for PGI and T. Arun Babu book for JIPMER, so which will specially Manoj Chaudhary sir's books for PGI and T. Arun Babu for JIPMER, so they will particularly address this kind of question pattern. But now everything is mixed. So when you solve a last year question paper, like as I said, like Pritesh Singh sir's INI Essence or NEET Essence. So you can go to the bookshop and open this book literally, and you can see if it contains like it has given like PGI 2018 or JIPMER 2016. So that pattern is going to help you. That is going to work in your favor. So if you think that a lot of the exams you did not get good results, so these are the reasons why you are not getting the good results, because everything matters. When you go and write your NICT, suddenly you feel it's a difficult exam. Suddenly you feel that I'm not able to match up with the questions and their answers. The reason is not the questions are difficult. Most of the student, I called one student and said, how was the exam or NICT? And the person replied to me, sir, it was very basic. Everything was from the basic, but still, they are not expecting a good rank. Reason being, you are not ready for the pattern either. The information is insufficient, but you are also not ready for the pattern. So these things are takeaway and home, like take home messages for you. So whenever you write the exam, don't let it be your exam. It's okay. You can tell yourself, okay, I was not ready, but still you want a good rank, right? So work on all these factors. You have to be ready for the exam pattern. So practice the MCQs which address the PGI pattern, which address the JIPMER pattern, and that you can go through these MCQ books. I'm not asking you to increase your base a lot, but this is going to help you. And again, at last, again, emphasizing on the first ed, USMLE first ed, this is book, it should be handy. A lot of students ask me, sir, when should I read it? And how should I read it? I told you guys, just spare 30 minutes or 45 minutes daily for whenever you are like tired or feel like, okay, I don't want to solve MCQs during that period, or after food, you are feeling like I want to read something interesting, you can always read this book. So at least you have to read book thrice before your exam to have a good recall, because every sentence of this book is high yield. So that can be very helpful in particularly NICT. So guys, let this NICT November 2021 be used as a, it should show you a path that how can you improve further. Don't just keep writing exam and say that no, my target is something else or different. Again, NICT, you can get, I have done it, my friends have done it, we have completed our graduate post graduation from AIIMS, and these all things have helped us. So definitely you can also go to AIIMS and PGI or JIPMER and definitely complete your dream. So that's all, guys. So that's what I wanted to tell about NICT November 2021. So I wish you guys all the best. Keep working hard until you reach your dream. And if you have any questions and doubt, let me know in the comment box, and also let me know about what do you feel about this video. Guys, take care.